Hello students, welcome to my channel. Today we will discuss some important Indian books to be part of English literature competitive exams. Indian authors have contributed to many incredible, priceless gems in the fictional literature around the whole world, and many of them have won too many awards for their efforts. Here are a few works of fiction by Indian authors that definitely need to be in everybody's must-read list, as well as it can be a part of exams. The first one we are covering today is An Autobiography, The Story of My Experiment with Truth by Mahatma Gandhi. The second one, Autobiography of an Unknown Indian by Neeraj C. Chaudhary. The next one, White Tiger by Arvind Adiga. Train to Pakistan by Khushwant Singh. The next, Heat and Dust by Ruth Prawar Jawala. A Fine Balance by Rohintan Mistry. Fasting Feasting by Anita Desai. The list doesn't end here, but in a video we can cover some limited books only. An Autobiography, The Story of My Experiment with Truth, contains Gandhi's recollection of his life experience up to 1921. This book was originally written in Gujarati, the Mahatma's mother tongue. The autobiography was written as weekly journals and other compiled and published work as a book. From his childhood memories, his experiment with eating meat, smoking, drinking, and stealing to the demise of his father, the book captures many unknown instances of his life. Other notable works by Mahatma Gandhi are Hind Swaraj, written in 1909, and Satyagraha in South Africa, written in 1924, and English translation was done in 1928. The next one that we are covering today is Autobiography of an Unknown Indian by Neeraj C. Chaudhary, which was published in 1951. Let us get acquainted with the writer first. Neeraj C. Chaudhary was born in 1897 and his birthplace was Kishoreganj, which is presently part of Bangladesh. He did his bachelor's from the Scottish Church College, Calcutta, and won Sahitya Academy Award for his biographical work on Max Müller, which was titled Scholar Extraordinary and published in 1941. The Autobiography of an Unknown Indian is the memoir of an ordinary Indian who was well educated in the British way of life. The first edition of this book was published by Jaiko Publishing House. It records his life from his birth in 1897 in Kishoreganj, a small town in present-day Bangladesh. This book was written when he was around 50. Neeraj C. Chaudhary, who was born in 1897 and died in 1999, is considered to be one of the finest writers of English in the 20th century. He surely holds the record for being the world's oldest author, and this remarkable man published a book in his 99th year, Three Horsemen of New Apocalypse. The preface of this book goes like this. The very first thing I have to tell those who will read this book in his preface to Three Horsemen of the New Apocalypse is that it is being written by a man in his 99th year. The book is about judgments on great variety of 20th century issues in the Western world. The next one we are covering is White Tiger by Arvind Adiga. This is his debut novel and it won 2008 coveted Man Booker Prize. It was published in 2008 and got the award in the same year. The novel provides a very dark, humorous perspective of India, Indians' struggle, Indians' class struggle in this modern globalized world, and it is told from a village boy's point of view whose name is Balram Halwai. In detailing Balram's journey first to Delhi, where he works as a chauffeur to a rich landlord, and then to Bangalore, the place to which he flees after killing his master and stealing his money. The novel examines too many issues prevailing in India, like issues of religion, issue of caste loyalty, caste discrimination, corruption, and poverty. Let us know the author now. Arvind Adiga was born in 1974 in Madras, which is now called Chennai. His second novel, Last Man in the Tower, was published in 2011. His latest novel, Selection Day, was published in 2016. The next one is very famous, Train to Pakistan, published in 1956 by the prominent Indian writer Khushwant Singh. It is the first historical novel of Khushwant Singh, also titled as Mano Majra. In this classic novel, Khushwant Singh tells about Sikhs and Muslims who used to live in peace for hundreds of years in India, and the novel is based upon the Hindu-Muslim riots of 1947, which occurred due to partition. Khushwant Singh. Khushwant Singh is one of the most prominent names in the field of Indian literature, and he doesn't need any kind of formal introduction, but still we need to know him a bit. Khushwant Singh was born in the year 1915 in Hadali, Pakistan, and he died on 20th March 2014. He is the most famous for his historical novel Train to Pakistan, which was published in 1956. He was also the founder and editor of IGNOU. In 1974, he was honored the Padma Bhushan by India's president. In the year 2007, he was awarded with Padma Vibhushan. Some of the other notable works by Khushwant Singh are Why I Supported the Emergency, Delhi, a novel, I Shall Never Hear a Nightingale, The Portrait of a Lady, collected stories. The next book that we are covering is Heat and Dust by Ruth Prawal Jhabwala, which was published in 1975. Heat and Dust is a novel by Ruth Prawal Jhabwala, which won the Booker Prize in 1975. It is set in colonial India during 1920s and tells the story of a girl, Olivia, a beautiful, you can say either girl or woman, suffocated by the propriety and social constraints of her position as the wife of an important civil English servant, longing for passion and independence. Let us know the writer now. She was a Booker Prize winning novelist, born on May 7, 1927 in Germany and died on April 3, 2013 at the age of 85 in Manhattan, New York. She was a writer known for Howards End's A Room with a View and The Remains of the Day. Won 2 Oscars for her adaptations of E.M. Forster's novel A Room with a View and Howards End, and the Booker Prize for her novel Heat and Dust. She remains the only person to have won an Oscar and the Booker, both. Okay, the next one is A Fine Balance by Rohinton Mistry. A Fine Balance is a novel by Rohinton Mistry, which was published in 1995 and tells the story of a diverse group of characters living in India during the time of Indira Gandhi's emergency, though the name of Mrs. Indira Gandhi has never been mentioned in the novel. Let us know about the author and his awards. Rohinton Mistry was born on 3rd July 1952 and is an Indian-born Canadian writer. In 2008, he published The Scream, 2002, Family Matters, 1995, A Fine Balance, 1992, Tales from Firozshahbagh, which was a UGC NET question of 2019 exam, 1991, Such a Long Journey, and he has got following awards in 2012, Newstead International Prize for Literature, 2011, Man Booker International Prize, 1995, Giller Prize in Canada. The last one for the day is Fasting Feasting by Anita Desai. Fasting Feasting takes on Desai's greatest theme, the intricate, delicate web of family conflict. It tells the moving story of Uma, the plain older daughter of an Indian family tied to the household of her childhood and tending to her parents' every extravagant demand, and of her younger brother Arun across the world of Massachusetts. Anita Desai, whose original name was Anita Mazumdar, was born on June 24, 1937 in India, in Missouri. She is English language Indian novelist and author of many children's books. Her novels include Fire on the Mountain, which was published in 1977 and won Winifred Holtby Memorial Prize, and Clear Light of the Day in 1980, In Custody 1984. In 2014, she has also won Padma Bhushan Award. So that is all for this video. In my part 2 video of the same topic, I'll try to cover more writers who can be the part of any kind of literature competitive examination. Please do not forget to subscribe our channel. You can gain more and more knowledge about literature through this channel. Contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks a lot for watching. Best of luck for your exam.